Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. We're here with Wilbur and Gulliver. It's a shame you can't really see it behind this thing. We've made this generator type thing with the water, powering the hamster wheel and making electricity by rubbing the balloon, and somehow this provides all this electricity. Anyway, Gulliver's agreed to help, let us out in exchange for his help, but first he has to finish making these magic, or not magic, slates. And, he'll be done in 2 to 3 weeks. Apparently, he'll need his wife's help, who's in here. Her name's Esther?
Hi! You must be Esther!
Yoo-hoo!
Yoo-hoo!
Hi, Nate! I'm sorry if I scared you earlier.
Oh, it's a little Nate. Grup. Cozy cave you've got here.
I think it's great what you've done for yourselves here. The workshop, this cave.
Very colorful wall.
We have tried really hard. And it will do for us. A little home for a little family.
I think Gulliver sees that differently. Seems to me he's already planning for life in a palace.
He's very optimistic. I think we should be content with what we have. If you're always dreaming about the future, you miss the here and now.
Dreaming doesn't do any harm. I think you deserve more.
Sure, but you deserve better. Why should you be content with living in a junkyard?
Well, we are zombies. We don't have any money. We're lucky to even be here.
It shouldn't matter who or what you are. You can make it.
What do you think of Bill, the merchant?
Gulliver's very enthusiastic about Bill.
Yes, he thinks he will help us.
But you don't think so?
Oh, what do I know? I'm just a simple girl trying to take care of her family.
Yeah, don't trust Bill.
But my head was chopped off. Just because I'm a zombie. I'm really not sure if the people in Seastone will take to us, however hard we might try.
I'm helping Gulliver with your slate delivery. How are the fluffy covers for them doing?
Gulliver's promised to take me to the surface with you if I help you with the delivery. He said you're making the fluffy pink covers for the slates.
Oh, I'm not ready yet. And it's not a cover. I'm trying to mix a fluffy paint.
A fluffy paint?
Fluffy paint.
Yes. There are hardly any fluffy materials or furs down here. But old paint and chemicals are here in abundance.
I've never heard of fluffy paint.
Well, there are warm colors, cold colors, neon colors. Why shouldn't there also be fluffy colors?
You mean pastel? Perhaps you should think a bit more about covers or something of that sort.
I'm not sure if a fluffy paint is the right way.
It's the only way. We have to work with what we've got.
But you don't got that.
I'm sure that a good alchemist could find the correct mixture.
Ethel.
Ah, I know someone who's good at alchemy.
Really? Would he help us?
She.
I don't think so. She's actually the cook in the rats' camp.
Oh, the same old story.
Why don't you like each other? I mean, zombies and rats, not you personally.
The rats are lovely, and you folks are easy to get along with, too. Why don't you like each other?
Oh, it all went a bit badly wrong. We had a long journey.
Yes.
We lay down in the rubbish to have a bit of a rest. At some point, I woke up and saw a rat nibbling at one of my fingers. She must have mistook me for a discarded tidbit. I only realized this much later. I was very surprised and shouted very loudly.
Ew! And then?
Gulliver jumped up to defend me. In doing so, he pushed over a heap of junk that buried him as well as the leg of the fleeing rat. Gulliver was shouting wild threats out and trying to free himself from the rubbish. I went over to the little rat to try and help her. She must have took fright. She gnawed off her leg and limped away.
That's Ethel.
That's truly a tragic story.
Since then, Gulliver believes all rats have it in for us. He wants to protect me.
And Ethel thinks you're monsters.
He won't let any rat into the vicinity of our home and has forbidden Nate and myself to talk to them.
Would you let a rat help you create the paint?
But if Ethel the cook wanted to help, would you let her?
Of course. Why not? We just must tell Gulliver about it. He would never allow a rat into our house.
That's the smaller of the two problems. The larger is Ethel.
If only we could speed up production.
Even if you find the right paint, Gulliver thinks it would still take weeks to complete the delivery.
It's hard work, and Gulliver is working as quickly as he can.
There must be a faster way to build the slates.
Ooh.
Nate thinks so too. That's why he built the constructor. Unfortunately, it doesn't work.
It would make things go faster.
Huh. Beep doodle doot.
Well, not much faster. It would still take a few hours.
That's a lot faster than 3 weeks. Nate seems to be following in his father's footsteps as far as inventing things is concerned.
Nate and Gulliver seem to have no blood in their veins.
No, Nate has no blood. Gulliver might have something sticky in him.
That's
formaldehyde.
Not what I meant. I meant they both like to invent things.
Yeah, you're figuratively.
That's right. They used to make things together. But now, because Gulliver has so much to do, he doesn't have any time for it anymore. I know. But Papa is only working hard, so he'll have more time for you later.
Quite an interesting family we've got here. Well, I'm going to see if I can get Ethel to help us. See ya.
I suggest you keep on going for now. In the meantime, I'll go and see if I can win Ethel over to our cause.
You do that.
Take care, Nate. And you have nothing to fear from us, gnomes.
Yes, Nate. Wilbur is a gnome.
That was one syllable.
You remember them from your book, don't you? Nate has a book about the races in Aventasia. It's his favorite. I have to read it to him every evening.
I'd love to look at it myself.
Yes, a gnome.
Jaloot.
Yes, gnomes.
Nate thinks he has at last found another inventor.
Inventor?
The book says that all gnomes love tinkering and inventing.
Not this gnome.
Oh, gnome.
Wow, we get to look around this place now. Oh, look at all these goodies to look at. Let's look at the pots.
Esther has a collection of different paints and lacquers, but whether or not they can be used to produce the desired paint, I have absolutely no idea. I should let her keep working on her paint. Even if I don't think she has a chance without Ethel's help.
Oh, did Nate make these drawings?
Pictures of Nate, I'd say. Most show trees, flowers, and clouds.
Pictures of Nate. Pictures from Nate. Or by Nate, not of Nate.
An empty birdcage?
Oh, Nate often feels lonely when Gulliver and I have to work. We thought a bird might be a bit of company for him.
There's no bird in there.
I'm making good progress. I've already found a bat wing and a few frog eyes.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
They're making a put-together zombie Frankenstein bird-type thing. There's sand in there.
It's fine white sand. I can't just put it in my pocket. I need some sort of container.
Put in your little baggie. Your little baggie here.
Handfuls of sand should be enough.
Enough for what, though?
The world's smallest sandbag. Too small for even me to train on. Not that I planned on it. Training, that is. I bet it's not easy for Nate. He has the best playground anyone could ever imagine, but no playmates. I bet it's not...
Hmm.
Let me guess. This is one of Nate's inventions.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Sorry, guys.
It makes us breakfast every morning.
Cool.
It works?
Let's just say the next thing on my wish list is a machine that will clean the kitchen up after breakfast.
You want a washing machine. Alright, so we've got a model here of a kingdom.
What is it?
A map of Aventasia.
Sweet.
Nate built it. He often likes to dream of traveling across the lands.
He's never been up there?
No. But I tell him about it every evening, and he has his books.
The map is made from old sheet metal and recycled parts. Must have taken forever. I really hope one day Nate gets a chance to visit some of these places.
Alright, that'd be neat. Oh, we got a little socket wrench here.
A small socket wrench. Nate must have used it to build the map. I'm sure he won't mind if I borrow it.
Handy socket wrench. Looks like a key.
This wrench looks like new. Wonder why it was thrown away. Neighbor probably had a bigger one.
It's like she stops because she's listening to him. Stab into the little sack?
I'm sure I could use that to pierce a hole in the sack, but then the sand will slowly flow out.
Okay. Rope with stone and sandbag.
The rope helped me once. Maybe it can again.
Okay. Mounting?
Esther's equipment isn't all that bad. The main problem seems to be a lack of experience.
Take the mounting.
Do you need this stand, Esther?
I don't know. Do I need it?
I asked you.
No idea, but I think I need it.
How do you know?
I have no idea. The walkthrough says so. I've got this feeling.
I get a feeling. Whenever something catches my eye, I should take it. Sooner or later, I'll find a use for it.
I do that too. That's why I've got so much useless stuff here. Take whatever you like.
Thank you. Yep, take everything that isn't bolted down. And maybe we can unbolt some of the things that are.
A device that can be used to hold glass flasks, test tubes and stuff.
Oh, it's a portrait. Of who?
A portrait, painted by Esther. Could be a relation of Gulliver.
Oh, well, there's a portrait of, Nate.
This looks like scales used by some of the merchants in the market. This one's broken. One of the pans is missing. Do you want me to see if I can find a second pan for the scales, Esther?
Oh, don't. Just leave it. I'll mix the color by eye. You're welcome to take the scales with you if you want.
Ooh! Might prove useful. Thank you.
Thanks.
The scales are useless for weighing anything. One of the pans is missing.
Hang the scales on the mounting?
Why not? The scales are suspended from the stand. If I had a second pan, I could weigh something.
Okay. Anything else here?
I bet it's not easy for Nate.
It's the one thing we can't move. I mean, can't take with us. That too. Put the cloak over the cage. Let's make the bird be quiet. But there is no bird. Okay. Out.
My son says you could help him with his constructor.
TM.
I told him you said you weren't an inventor, but you did sort out the electricity, and Nate says all gnomes are inventors. In theory, yes. Practically seen, I'm practically not practical at all. But the constructor could save us a lot of time once it's up and running, and you are in a hurry, aren't you? I could have a look. Where's the problem? We need a strong fan belt. All the ones Nate tried so far have torn. And we need coal for the steam machine. Wood and garbage don't burn hot enough. I still can't say for sure whether the machine will actually work. Not all of Nate's inventions work at the first go. Hey! V-belt and coal. Sounds doable. But don't forget, we still need the fluffy paint as well. How could I? Work never stops.
I know where the V-belt is.
It looks like you'll have some help. Don't cause any mischief, boys.
All right, maybe he can stand on my head and get the V-belt.
Hi, Gulliver. Hello, Wilbur.
I need a bit of the intelligent stone. I do.
I need some of the intelligent rock. For the constructor? Of course. Help yourself.
Glad I asked.
See you later, Gulliver. Bye for now, Wilbur.
Anything else?
If I disturb him for no reason...
Yeah.
Ooh, the rock is lighter than I thought. And it's warm. I should get rid of it as quickly as possible. It gives me the creeps.
It's sentient rock.
The constructor is supposed to saw both the magic rock and the boards and assemble everything all on its own. Pretty complex task, if you ask me. This monster could speed slate delivery production up so much that we could even finish that last delivery for Bill today. All we have to do is get this machine wound up and rolling.
This looks a lot bigger than before.
The fire in the furnace heats the kettle above it, turning the water to steam, making the pressure rise. The hotter the fire, the better. We need coal.
Flywheel?
The large flywheel drives the machine. However, there's no connection to the steam engine. Have your V-belts failed? So we need a really strong one.
I know where it is.
The large flywheel, however... So we need...
Look at the little something. Little something-something.
That's... firework. At the end of the war, there was a huge victory celebration in Seastone with lots of rockets and firecrackers. Several fires broke out and the town was damaged more severely than any time during the war. I wish that was more surprising, really. I don't have anything to celebrate, but maybe I can use the black powder for something. A small pile of black powder. Enough for a small bang, nothing more.
Okay. Funnel, I guess that's where you put the coal.
Okay, as I understand it, the raw materials are fed into the machine through this funnel, right? Okay, that would be wooden planks and some of the intelligent rock. Okay, that would be wooden plank.
Okay, let's put the stuff in there now.
I think the constructor would likely work better with short boards than with long ones. The necessary raw materials are in the machine. Now we just have to start it up.
This oil can?
We might have to oil it once the machine is up and running. It's not necessary at the moment because the machine is well oiled. Good job, Nate.
Alright, so we might have to go for this once the thing is running.
Does this indicator show how effectively the machine's running? Then we'll have to keep an eye on it once we're rolling.
So after we get this thing started, we gotta watch it.
Do these levers control the constructor?
All that, huh?
You don't need to explain everything to me now. We need to get this baby working first.
So who can understand that?
Do these levers... You don't need to explain...
So this chain...
Any steam-powered machine worth its salt has a whistle like this. Without the engine running, not much is going to happen. But once it is running, I'll be the first to pull it. Okay, the second.
Well, unless those extender arms go out really far, I don't know how you're going to reach it. Alright, we have to, like, get stuff, so...
Hey, Nate!
I saw the map that you created. Well, the model.
I've seen the map you made. Although, you can hardly call it a map, it's almost a miniature world. Yes, all the mountains and forests and cities. And you learned all that from only books and your parents' stories. I can't even imagine what it must be like to never have left this place. Blue sky, green trees, fresh air. You've got so much to see. I'll get you out of here, Nate. I promise.
And you really built the constructor?
I know what a little ingenuity and ambition can accomplish. I come from a gnome family. But the constructor? This is a truly impressive piece of technology. Yes, if we can get it working, the delivery should be ready in a jiffy.
That's what he said, huh? What do we need to get the constructor TM running again?
What do we need to get the constructor operational?
I know. Coal and V-belt.
Right. Coal for the steam engine and a strong V-belt. That's what Gulliver said, too.
Well, nice chatting to you.
Time for work.
A firework? Was that there before?
Ooh, another firework. Pile of black powder.
Is that... Did we take the powder out of the firework? Is that what happened?
The clock isn't ticking.
Oh, here.
The wrench could actually fit. It's worked! It's ticking!
Poo-poo.
I'll set the hands to 12 o'clock.
Take the bird.
The bird really has seen better days. It's losing its feathers.
Okay, so that's what we wanted to do that for.
A pretty little feather. This bird has definitely seen better days. Almost looks a bit scary.
Oh, for Nate.
Hey, Nate, I have something for you. For you. For the empty bird cage. My pleasure.
Let's tape him up now.
Hey, Nate. Time for work.
Now, what if I put gunpowder in here? No? Or in there? No? Okay. Gotta tell him about the bird? Alright, let's go.